Hello guys, this is Raymond from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Startup News. Debt worth $100 million that ride-sharing company Ola Electric Mobility raised from Bank of Baroda last month has gone to its wholly-owned subsidiary Ola Electric Technologies Private Limited. Regulatory filing sourced through business intelligence platform Toffler. Ola Electric Technologies was set up in January to specifically manufacture 2, 3 and 4-wheeler electric vehicles. Ola Electric Mobility is a holding company for the newly incorporated entity and owns 100% stake in Ola Electric Technologies. And the company also said that the loan from Bank of Baroda was the largest long-term debt financing agreement in Indian electric vehicle industry. And Ola Mobility has also infused another 250 crore rupees, a mix of debt and equity, into a new company, according to the filing. Groofers has started 10-minute online grocery delivery service in 10 cities. Groofers customers can now order more than 7,000 everyday essential items in Delhi, Gurugram, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Jaipur, Ghaziabad, Noida and Lucknow. Today they are launching their 10th city with the promise to deliver groceries within minutes to your doorstep. And they mention that their average delivery times are still hovering around 15 minutes mark, but their vision is to get below 10 minutes for every customer in India. Alinder, the founder and chief executive of Groofers, also tweeted about this service. Ather Energy, in a newspaper notice published on Wednesday, warned readers of fake website that disputably similar to their website. The website attempting to imitate Ather Energy is atherenergydealership.com. It urges customers to place an order for an Ather scooter by making a payment of ₹2,999, and it says that it is fully refundable. The Hero MotoCorp backed firm has initiated legal action to take down this fake website. Application program interface platform Postman has raised around $225 million in new funding led by existing investors, Insight Partners, along with new investors like Kotao, Storied, Silicon Valley Investors, Mary Meeker's Bond Capital and Battery Ventures joining the round. Post this funding, Postman is now valued at $5.6 billion. This makes a 7-year-old startup the most valued software as a service firm from India. It is overtaking the browser stack, which was valued at $4 billion in June. Postman was founded in Bengaluru in 2014, Postman was valued at $2 billion a year ago after it raised $150 million in funding from Insight Partners and others. Postman is a tool for the creation of APIs that enables interaction between application as well as functionalities within the app. Postman existing investors Nexus Venture Partners and CRV has also participated in the new financing. Company is planning to use a new capital for expanding its team and invest in its community of developers. It has around 17 million users and 500,000 organization on its platform. India's anti-monopoly watchdog has approved Zomato's request to invest in online grocery platform Groofers India and its wholesale entity Hands On Trades. On Friday, the Competition Commission of India wrote on Twitter that it had approved the proposed acquisition by Zomato of approximately 9.3% of stake in Groofers India and Hands On Trades. India's used car is likely to see significant technology-driven growth in the coming years as people shun public transport in the aftermath of COVID-19 pandemic. The car services and repair market is likely to grow at a compounded annual growth rate of 12% to reach $25 billion by 2030 as compared to $8 billion last year. This sector, fragmented and largely unorganized, has in recent years witnessed an influx of startups that are using technology to provide services. From doorstep pickup to post-service warranty to customers, these companies are also offering services to offline workshops, providing them with affordable spare parts and efficient logistics. Travel booking application Ixigo is looking to raise ₹750 crore through a primary fundraise and ₹850 crore via an offer for sale from existing investor as part of its initial public offering. Last month, as part of its pre-IPO round, the company raised around $53 million, that is around ₹395 crore, from investors led by Singapore Sovereign Wealth Fund GIC with participation from investors such as InfoHedge Ventures, White Oak, Bay Capital, Oris Venture Partners, Trifactor Capitals and Malabar Investors. The company is currently being valued at around $850 million and it is likely to launch its IPO later this year. The company said that it will use this 550 crore rupees of the IPO proceeds to power its organic and inorganic growth initiatives. Direct to consumer beauty company MyGlam has acquired parenting platform Baby Chakra to expand its operation in South Asia. With this acquisition, MyGlam and Baby Chakra will be investing rupees 100 crore in building a mother and baby content to commerce platform over the next 3 years. This acquisition talks began in 2020 and were finalized this month. As part of the acquisition, Naya Sajji, the founder and CEO of Baby Chakra, will join MyGlam as a co-founder and president. Sajji will spearhead the mother and baby vertical and build out the overall community vertical for MyGlam. She will also be joining the MyGlam board. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.